Hi everybody and welcome to Westlife Q&A. So what we've done is we want to know what you want to know about our brand new album Spectrum. So we have a load of questions in this little bowl that you have sent in via social media and we're going to answer them.
We're looking forward to it.
Sounds like a plan.
I bet there's going to be some interesting ones.
Who wants to go first?
Looks like a lot of questions. I'm going to go right to the bottom.
Close your eyes. Can't look.
This comes in from at Lottie's Buy Me Now. Thank you at Lottie's Buy Me Now. What percentage of the tracks on the album our ballads.
Oh,
now,
Shane.
Our mathematician in the band is none other than
accountant
Mr. Shane Filan. So Shane, what percentage of the album is ballads?
27%.
Thank you very much, Lottie. What's next?
Three ballads.
Three ballads?
Yeah, roughly.
I would have said more.
Anyway, yeah.
Right,
maybe 35%.
Who'd like to go next?
I'll go next.
A rhythmical ballad.
Okay, Mark's going to go next. Sorry, Shane.
It's okay.
I'm picking two for myself. I'm so greedy.
You're greedy.
Marky, who's this from?
This comes in from Michelle Cold. Were there any other contenders for the album name?
It's funny, we were just talking about that.
Actually, the whole concept, or the name, or the concept of the name, kind of came quite early.
Before the even songs came. Mm.
We were going to call it the best album ever, but we thought it sounded a little bit too like One Direction, didn't we? So.
That was Nicky's idea. I thought it was a bit cocky, but you know.
I think you just made up that story just there, Nicky.
So, actually, no, there wasn't. It's been Spectrum since day one.
Okay, this next question comes in from at Lorna Priscott. I hope I pronounced that right. How long did it take to create the album? Ooh. It took us 14 months, exactly. We started last June when nobody knew we were even together. We were in the studio. We did the Steve Mac in London and recorded Better Man as our first song. We finished off our last song in Dublin last week. So that's.
Can anyone remember the very first vocal and the very last vocal?
The very first vocal would have been the
you
first
and I
person.
Have something very special, baby.
Yeah.
By Mr. Shane Filan.
And the last vocal, I actually recorded a little video on my phone that I will share with everybody
which
soon.
Is which is the uh-ohs.
Which is the group.
And Steve Mac was in the band that day too.
Yeah, he was.
But the last vocal was, who was the last person in the booth that day?
All four of us and Steve.
Doing like a group chant thing, which you will hear.
We were like football fans.
Okay, next question is from CLS Designs. Do you feel this is your best album yet?
Ooh. Do you know CLS, thanks for the...
CSL even.
Did you
see CSL Designs, apologies.
Oh, okay.
Just in case
I don't think it's our best album yet.
Good for you. I think every album that we make feels like the best album yet, but it definitely feels like the best album we've made this year.
I love it.
I think it is the best album.
I think it's the best quality.
It's by far the best album we've made this year, 100%.
Yeah. Promise. No, it is a brilliant album. That's
you'll have to, this year.
You'll have to get, no, ever. It's ever. You'll have to get
decide.
It to find
it's
it.
It's up to you to decide.
Right, back to you, Nicky.
This one comes in from at Eganaholic. That's somebody who just
somebody
can't,
that is,
they just get some Egan
kid.
Every day.
Thank you.
Drinks Egan, eats Egan, sleeps Egan. And they say, Keane, I'm going to let you answer this because they're Eganaholic. Three words to describe the album.
I would say colourful.
Oh.
Hence the title Spectrum.
Energetic,
I would say, energetic was a word we used yesterday, which will stick. It's an energetic album. And I would say also emotional.
That's three
brilliant.
Words. Thank
Ian,
you,
that is really sums it up, I think.
Back to you, Mark.
Mark.
An emotional Westlife album. There's a surprise.
What colour?
So, this one comes in from Kirsty Chalmers, X. What's your favourite song on the new album and why?
Go.
I assume that we're allowed to... talk about
Travis. My Blood is a song written by Ed Sheeran and Steve Mack. It's about life, it's about growing up, just dealing with everything in life. That's my favourite. It's called My Blood. Check it out.
Okay, and you're next because I can
I'm next. I'm going to say Dance because Westlife had a song called Dance and it was one of them songs that we found very, very late and it's just a tune.
I'm going to say my favourite song is Hello My Love because I'm sorry about, you know, I have to get in there.
Second.
For a long time, we were very worried about finding the right comeback single and it just couldn't have found a better song. And we performed it 50 times on tour because we just done 50 gigs on our tour and I loved it every single time.
Here's a question for you. If Ed Sheeran had when he called us up, if he had said to us, and Steve, listen, I give you Shape of You, Castle on the Hill, or Hello My Love as your comeback, what would you go?
That'd be Shape of You.
Shape of You?
Biggest song of all time, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Shane, your favourite song?
My favourite song, I was going to be Hello My Love, but after I'm going to go with Take Me There, which is a new song that we've got.
Written by?
Written by myself and Mark and Steve Mack and Camille.
Last song recorded on the album.
The last song recorded on the album.
To
and
finish.
It's a really good feel good up-tempo song and it could be a single in the future, who knows?
Jen,
check it out.
You're next.
Okay. This is from at Ali.bees.
Oh, hey Ali. She likes dot bees.
Why is the new album called Spectrum? The new album is called Spectrum because we feel, or Mark actually came up with the idea for the title of the album, but it kind of describes the album in a colourful sense. It's got loads of different...
Variety,
taste, colour,
it represents
ingredients.
The fact that when we came back, you know, I think it would have been very easy to just go down the old route of stick on the suits, record an album of covers, and just be like them old lads that used to be in a boy band. But we felt like we were much younger than that. We had a lot more to give. And I thought something colourful represented that youthfulness and energy that we still have left.
See? And we thought Rainbow wouldn't have been kind of worked. So yeah. We thought Spectrum was a better version.
Mariah has
a
album.
Is it me? Or is it you?
It's me. Now, I can't really pronounce this person's name.
At?
Percy and Go One.
Yeah, that's it.
Percy and Go
Percy,
One.
Percy
and Go
There's
One.
Two there.
Okay, first three singles are lit. Right?
Well, okay. Do you know what that means now?
No. Yeah.
Your dad.
It's young people talk.
They're lit. They're like, you know, I'm tired. Yeah.
We're down.
So the first three singles are lit. What can we expect from the rest of the Spectrum? I honestly think that, you know, from a Westlife album, this isn't a typical Westlife album. We certainly have a lot of the Westlife sounds in there, the big power ballads, the emotional kind of lyrics, things like that. But I think the biggest surprise of this album is generally the tempo.
Yeah.
It's probably the most tempo we've had in one album.
73% up tempo.
11 songs. You're calling the mid tempo. Yeah, it's mad.
You see,
it's rhythmic.
My blood
it's
still is tempo. Though.
Yeah. You know what it is? It's just a great pop album.
It's a brilliant pop album.
I would say also, it's our least kind of funerally album.
Interesting.
There's no funeral songs on there.
It's quite a party.
Well, until you get to like 10 o'clock at the funeral and then everyone's drunk. Maybe then.
I like this question from, it's coming from Tess D. Hey Tess. She says, will it be released on vinyl? And the answer to that is yes.
Okay, so this one is from Carol C. Poblete.
Poblete.
Yeah, I mean.
That's Italian,
Carol
I think.
C. P. Poblete. It could be Carol C. P. Olete, whatever. Anyways, you out there. What inspired the album cover? I always thought that when you look at iTunes, you know, a lot of it all just blends in together, and I wanted something that was a block color that stood out. And I think that it's fair to say that if you look at our album cover on iTunes, for instance, or various other platforms, that it's just a block sort of vibrant blue color. And it certainly does stand out. Would you agree, lads?
It does. And you kind of referenced our first album too, Mark, in that, didn't you? With the faces.
Our first album had our five heads at the time.
Before we move on, this is the last question.
Who does the last question?
The last question comes from Ash Gwen Ike, I think.
Ike.
Is there a new music style to be expected from the new album? Yes, very much so. We feel that this is a 2019 version of Westlife. As we said earlier, it's very upbeat. It's quite modern for Westlife. It's not like you've heard before from really any of our albums. But we feel like it's a new sound that we want to bring into the future.
But we have heard that this type of sound from other people. Like, we're not reinventing the wheel.
Yeah, I mean, Hello My Love is a new sound
pop.
For Westlife, but it's sort
still
of not
pop
crazy.
Pop
you know?
Music.
Oh, come
no
on,
more.
Just one more.
No more, Nicky.
Let's do one more question.
We have a lot of things to do today, so that's the end of the
Q&A.
We'll
be back after the
break.
Thank
you.
Did you like that?
Thank you for all that.